To be a good entomologist, you need to master the art of insect classification. For you to master the art of classification, you need to keep practicing and practicing all the time. For instance, once you have practiced perfectly well, you'll be classifying an insect housefly, for example. You'll be going as smooth as kingdom Animalia, phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Diptera, family Muscidae, genus Musca, species Domestica. This will be very helpful when you'll be out in the field doing your collection. The classification of insects actually are, in striving after a natural system of classification of insects, the characters of most importance in diagnosis include the presence of the wings or the absence, the mouth parts and the changes in their ontogeny, the metamorphosis and characters accorded by the antenna and tarsi. Others of the most importance to elementary students will be highlighted. In general, insects belong to phylum Arthropoda, subphylum Hexapoda, class Insecta, and they are usually identified and classified according to the, as I had said earlier, either the presence of or absence of wings, the number of wings, the type of metamorphosis, and the orientation of their mouth parts. First, according to the wings, insects can be classified as either winged or wingless. The winged insects are also known as pterygota. Pterygota means winged. The apterygota are the winged insects which do not have wings. They are also it's a character attributed to its primitive nature. Also, the number of wings is also another important factor to consider. These are the examples of the pterygota, and they are actually the first four orders, which are namely Tysanura, Protura, Diplura, and Columbola. Columbola, Protura, Diplura, and Tysanura are all ametabolous. As I said, they don't have wings and they don't undergo metamorphosis. They don't undergo any developmental stages. According to the orientation of the mouth parts, we have hypognathus. Hypognathus is a feature whereby the mouth part faces directly to the ground. I'll show you in another image. We are. An example is a locust. You can see the orientation of its mouth part. The mouth part is facing downward. We also have prognathus. The mouth parts are directly face forward. An example is the stick insects, the soja caste of termites, and here we have an example. Here we have this is not the soja, the termite, but the mouth part is also prognathus. It is horizontal to the ground. It's actually, we also have a good example here of prognathus. We also have opisthognathus. Opisthognathus is whereby the head is reflexed ventrally so that the mouth parts are directly backwards between the cocci of the front legs. An example is a red cottonback. We have an example here. Here and also here. Also, according to metamorphosis, as I had said earlier, the first four orders Tetaisanura, Diplura, Protura, and Columbula do not undergo any developmental stages, and they are known as ametaboli. And hemimetaboli or parametaboli are the insects which undergo incomplete metamorphosis, that is, egg, nymph, adult. And for the holometabola insects, these are the insects which undergo complete metamorphosis. That includes the egg, larvae, pupa, and adult. Actually, the definition of metamorphosis is the process of transformation from immature form to adult form in two or more distinct stages. Starting with ametaboli, as I said earlier, the first four orders do not undergo any metamorphosis. And we also have here hemimetaboli. And the example of insects that undergo hemimetaboli are the autopterans, with an example of the grasshoppers. And here we go. We have the stages egg, nymph, adult. The stage repeats again: egg, nymph, adult, again and again. For holometaboli insects, as I had said, we have the lepidopteran as an example. Lepidopterans are actually butterflies and moths. And here are the stages. We start with an egg, then larvae, pupa, adult. The adult lays eggs, then the process starts over and over again. Now here, let's just go through the important orders of insects. Actually, we have 29 orders of insects, and just for today, we'll look at the most important ones, starting with Orthoptera. Orthoptera are the locusts and grasshoppers. We also have the coleopterans, which are the beetles. We have lepidopterans, butterflies and moths, as I had said. Then we have diptera. Actually, diptera are the true flies. Examples are mosquitoes, houseflies, and the true flies actually are known as the true flies, as they have a pair of wings, and they have the halters. The halters, this allows them to fly in all dimensions, and that's why it's only the houseflies or the true flies which can land even on the roof, on the ceiling. I think you have seen a housefly which has landed on your ceiling. Those are the true flies. We also have the hymenopterans. These are the bees and wasps. Actually, the bees and wasps also belong to the class of, they belong to the social insects. And maybe I can just say a thing about the social insects. The social insects are the insects which they tend to take care of their young ones. They have a tendency of maternal care, which is usually associated with some reduction in the number of eggs which are laid and in the mortality of the early stages. A social insect may be defined as the one which parent and offspring live in a common abode. This mode of existence is made possible owing to the length of the life of the female parent, which allows association with her offsprings. So that is it. We also have the bugs. The bugs belongs to the order Hemiptera. We also have the order Homoptera, the another order Demaptera, which are the earwigs. We have the order Odonata, which the dragonflies. Actually, dragonflies are parasitoids, they feed on other insects. We also have the Isoptera. The Isopterans are the termites. They are also Social insects, since they all live in a common abode, they take care of their young ones. And we also have Mantodea, which are the praying mantis, and Platodea, the cockroaches. Actually, the Mantodea and Platodea all belong to one superorder, Dictyoptera. Although in some books, the cockroaches have been classified as being in the order Dictyoptera. So I hope that's a correction which can be made. Also, we have the order Neuroptera, which includes the antlions or antlions. Either antlion or antlions, you can call it whatever you want. It's the same. We also have the order Phasmida, which includes the stick insects. We also have the order Thysanoptera, which includes the thrips. We also have Ephemeroptera, with an example of the mayflies. Actually, the mayflies are very peculiar type of insects, whereby they spend most of their life as a larval form. And when they get to adulthood, they die just within a few hours. So they have a peculiar life. We also have Trichoptera. Example is the caddisflies. We have the Siphonoptera, which are the example of the fleas. We also have Malophaga, with an example with the biting flies as an example. We also have Spanculata, which are the sucking lice. And here, let's just have a summary of all what we have just said. As a summary of what we have said, we said the insects are divided or are classified according to either the presence of or absence of their wings, the orientation of their mouth parts, and the characters accorded by the antennas. Also, just very fast, we have three important insect subclasses. First, we have the subclass Apterygota, which includes the wingless insects. These insects have no wings and are termed as being primitive. They have slight or no metamorphosis. And examples, as I had said earlier, we have Thysanura, Protura, Diplura, and Colembola. We have another subclass, Pterygota. And as I had said earlier, the subclass Pterygota includes the insects which have wings. And in subclass Pterygota, this subclass is divided into two. We have Hexopterygota and we have Endopterygota. The Hexopterygota includes the insects which pass through a simple or sometimes slight metamorphosis and are rarely accompanied by pupal instar. The wings develop externally and the young ones are generally nymphs. Examples of this order include the Ephemeroptera, Odonata, Plecoptera, Grilloplatodea, Orthoptera, Phasmida, Damaptera, Embioptera, Dictyoptera, Isoptera, Zoroptera, Psocoptera, Malophaga, Sphanculata, Hemiptera, and Thysanoptera. We also have still in the subdivision of subclass Pterygota, we also have division Endopterygota. Actually, Endopterygota are the true holometabolous insects. These, as I had said earlier, are insects which pass through a complex metamorphosis, always accompanied by a pupal instar. The wings develop internally and the larvae are usually specialized. We have the examples of this are the order Neuroptera, order Megaptera, order Lepidoptera, the as I had said earlier, the butterflies, Trichoptera, the Diptera, as I had said, the true flies. Examples are the houseflies, the mosquitoes, and so forth. We also have the others, Siphonoptera. These are the an example are the we also have Hymenoptera, Coleoptera, and Strepsiptera. So, thanks for watching. That's the end.